Hello guys, this is Dr. Palnipur Manikam. Have you ever noticed how alcohol is everywhere? Weddings, birthdays, festivals, even a simple weekend get-together, there's always a drink involved. And it is glorified in movies, music videos, ads, making it look even more glamorous, fun and completely normal. But have you ever stopped to think about what alcohol actually does to your body? Not just the next day's hangover, but what happens inside your brain, gut and overall health over time. Let me break it down in a way that actually make sense. My friend Sarana Kumar dances for Jamal Kudu's song in Animal Movie by balancing the glass of alcohol on his head, only to create imbalance in his bodily function. He starts with Jamal Kudu, but the hospital says Bill Kudu. Let us start with the brain because that is where alcohol hits first. The moment you take a sip, alcohol enters your bloodstream and reaches your brain in just a few minutes. That is when you start feeling relaxed, talkative, and maybe even a little fearless. This happens because alcohol suppresses the part of your brain that controls self-control and decision-making, which is the prefrontal cortex. That is why after a few drinks, people make not so wise choices, send embarrassing texts, or say things they regret. Even moderate drinking, like one or two drinks a day, can cause brain to shrink over time. A massive study of over 35,000 people showed that even 7 drinks a week led to a measurable brain degeneration. That means memory issues, slower thinking, and increased risk of conditions like dementia. My friend Sarana Kumar has selective dementia. He's well aware of the route for wine shop, but forgets the way back home. If you have ever heard of blackouts, where people do not remember what happened the night before, it is because alcohol shuts down the hippocampus, the part of your brain responsible for making new memories. Alcohol addicts are very generous. They sacrifice their memories to provide endless entertainment and memorable moments for the friend who sticks to the side dishes. It is not just about forgetting what happened that night. Long-term alcohol use can permanently weaken the hippocampus, making it harder to learn new things or recall past events. Over time, this can contribute to early cognitive decline, even if you do not drink heavily. Now, one of the most common reasons people drink is to relax, forget someone, or escape stress. Many say a drink after work helps me unwind, but the irony is, alcohol actually increases stress in the long run. It messes with serotonin, the brain chemical that keeps your mood stable. At first, alcohol gives a temporary serotonin boost, making you feel happy. But as it leaves your system, serotonin drops, making you feel anxious, sad, or even depressed. And it gets worse. Alcohol disrupts your body's stress system called the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, HPA axis. If you drink regularly, your baseline cortisol, the stress hormone, stays high. That means even when you are not drinking, you feel more stressed. That is why people who drink often tend to feel more anxious over time. So that relaxing drink is actually doing the opposite. It is a trick, not the truth. Alcohol is like a toxic relationship that is fun at first, but later leads to heartbreak. Then HPA axis becomes one of your excess. Also, it damages your gut. Your gut is not just for digestion. It is directly linked to your brain. This connection is called the gut-liver-brain axis, which means whatever happens in your gut affects your brain and vice versa. But the problem is alcohol kills off the good bacteria in your gut, the ones that help with digestion, immunity, and even mood regulation. When these bacteria die, harmful bacteria take over, leading to digestive issues, bloating, and inflammation. My friend Sarana Kumar, after consuming alcohol, types angrily about his wife, Tribhura Sundari, but sends it to me. No guts to send it to her. And then there is a leaky gut syndrome. Alcohol weakens the intestinal lining, allowing toxins and bacteria to leak into your bloodstream. This triggers widespread inflammation, which is linked to everything from autoimmune diseases to anxiety and depression. Now, your liver has to work extra hard to clean up the mess. It breaks down alcohol into acetaldehyde, a toxic chemical that causes hangovers and damages cells. If your liver is overloaded, the inflammation increases and those inflammatory chemicals reach your brain, affecting your mood, memory, and even your cravings. People say that they drink alcohol to forget their past. It's not true at all, because they would forget their past, present, and their liver. Inflammation from alcohol does not just affect your brain and gut. It can also contribute to skin issues, joint pain, and fatigue. Many people do not realize that their chronic bloating, headache, or even poor sleep quality is due to alcohol consumption. This is why people who drink regularly experience brain fog, low energy, and increased hunger or cravings for junk food. Alcohol rewires the brain to crave more sugar and processed food. My US friend Mark Anthony had a habit of drinking alcohol whenever the weather was foggy, but now he's struggling with brain fog. Though the damage caused by alcohol is severe, you can still undo it by staying away from alcohol. Your body can heal and the damage can be reversed, but it takes time. If you cut out alcohol even for a few weeks, you will start noticing changes. Your sleep improves because alcohol ruins deep sleep. Your mood stabilizes as serotonin levels balance out. Your gut starts repairing itself, leading to better digestion and less bloating. Your energy levels increase because your liver is not overloaded. Even your immune system gets stronger when you quit alcohol. And if you give it a few months and stay away from alcohol, even your brain can recover. Studies show that quitting alcohol for just 2 to 6 months can reverse a lot of the damage, especially in younger people. Look, I'm not here to tell you what to do or ask you to quit alcohol, but if you have ever wondered why you feel anxious, sluggish, or just off, maybe it's time to look at alcohol differently. And I never support alcohol or wine, not even occasionally. We live in a culture where drinking is so normalized that saying no feels weird. But let us be honest, no one ever got smarter, healthier, or stronger by drinking alcohol. My friend Sarana Kumar criticizes my dietary choices, saying that I am boring and missing out on life's pleasures by not indulging in alcohol treats. He does diet shaming on me. So next time when someone offers you a drink, just pause, ask yourself, am I just following the crowd? Do I really want this? Or you want your brain, your gut, your family, and your future self to thank you? I prefer to make families happy by being a social media influencer rather than spoiling my family by being a social drinker. Have you ever noticed how alcohol affects your body, mind, or even your mood? Drop a yes if you've experienced it, or a no if you've never thought about it this way. And if this opened your eyes, share it with someone who needs to hear this. Stay happy, stay gutsy, may God bless you.